Hello students, we are going to start first chapter measurement of your class. So as I instruct you, kindly listen carefully and start learning at your home. And if you have any doubt, then we can clear those after reopening of school. First chapter is measurement, and here a few definitions are very important. I'm going to show you all the definitions. Kindly take a pencil in your hand and keep putting tick marks there. Those definitions you have to learn, and few relations of course are very important. Those relations also I'm showing you here, and you have to mark and keep learning, because we are going to apply these relations for solving numericals in this section.
Yes children, take pencil in your hand. Today I am going to complete from page 1 to page 10. See page 1, first definition is measurement. You can see the red box here. Measurement is the process of comparison of the given physical quantity with the known standard quantity of the same nature. Mark this definition. Actually, you might have noticed, whenever we want to buy clothes, we tell to the shopkeeper, 2 meter clothes or 5 meter clothes, you give me. If we want to buy potato, we say 2 kg of potato or 5 kg of potato, like this. You see here one numerical value and one unit is there in order to express measurement. This definition, so you are going to learn. Measurement is the process of comparison of the given physical quantity with the known standard quantity of the same nature. If it is mass, unit is kilogram, SI unit positively. If it is length, SI unit is meter. If it is time, SI unit is second. Other units you know. So in measurement, we always compare with the standard unit. What is unit? Kilogram, meter, second, rest all, whatever you have. These are the units, you know. See the second definition here. Unit. You have to learn it. Put a tick there. Unit is a quantity of a constant magnitude which is used to measure the magnitudes of other quantities of the same nature. Third question is, measurement consists of two things. See number 1 and number 2 mark here. Number 1 unit and number 2 numerical value. As right now I said 5 kilogram or 2 meter. So one numerical value is there and one unit is there. So physical quantity consists of numerical value and unit. So we express it like this, numerical value into unit. Next question is, what are the properties we must keep in our mind in order to choose an unit? So these are the 4 points you have to buy heart. Number 1, the unit should be of convenient size. It should not change. It should be possible to define. Next, you have to learn the definitions of fundamental unit with examples and derived units with examples. See the definition here. A fundamental unit is that which is independent of any other unit or which can neither be changed nor can be related to any other fundamental unit. What's the meaning of this? Have a look for this table here. See the red table? Here few fundamental quantities are given. Surely you have to by heart this. Length, mass, time, temperature, luminous intensity, electric current, amount of substance, angle, and solid angle. These all are the examples of fundamental units. If definition comes, this definition you have to write. You may see here, length is represented by the symbol M. Only the single unit you can see here. It means it does not depend on any other unit. These all are single. Mass, kilogram, time, second, temperature, Kelvin, luminous intensity, candela, electric current, ampere, amount of substance, mole, angle, radian, and solid angle, steradian. Alright? Now, derived units. Derived units are those which depend on the fundamental units. You please turn page 7. See here, a chart is given, a table is given. These all are the examples of derived units. See 1 to 16 you have here. You have some knowledge till 12. Suppose area. You know what is area? A general definition and their formulas you must learn, because we need these formulas in order to get their units. Area, you can see it is written here m square. How are you getting it? M square, length into breadth. SI unit of length is meter, and SI unit of breadth is also meter. So m into m, m square. Similarly, volume. Length into breadth into height. In place of length, SI unit meter, breadth also meter, height also meter. So it is m cube. Density, mass by volume. We know the definition. Density is the mass per unit volume. So we can represent it in formula mass by volume. What's the SI unit of mass? Kilogram. And what's the SI unit of volume? Meter cube. Page 3, you have few more definitions. Meter. You have two boxes here. You see definition of meter, bigger box and a smaller one. You will learn the definition of smaller one. What is meter? If it comes, you will write the meter was redefined in terms of speed of light, according to which 1 meter is the distance traveled by light in 1 by 299792458. Of a second in air. I repeat, 1 meter is the distance traveled by light in 1 by 299792458 of a second. This is the definition you have to learn. Next, question may come. Write the subunits of meter or multiple units of meter. Subunits of meter means the units which are smaller than meter. And multiple units of meter are those which are bigger than meter. These are the smaller units, centimeter, millimeter, micron, nanometer. About centimeter and millimeter you know. Nanometer and micrometer, these are the new units. These are used for measuring very small length. These relations you have to learn. 1 centimeter equal to 10 to the power minus 2 meter. Keep putting tick marks, please. 1 millimeter equal to 10 to the power minus 3 meter. 1 millimeter equal to 10 to the power minus 1 centimeter. Because 1 by 10 is 10 to the power minus 1. 1 micron equal to 10 to the power minus 6 meter. 1 micron equal to 10 to the power minus 4 centimeter. Or 1 micron equal to 10 to the power minus 3 millimeter. These are important for filling the blanks which may come in your semester exams. Multiple units. Bigger units are, first one is kilometer, you know, 1 kilometer equal to 1000 meter, put tick there. Other bigger units are here, turn the page, 4, astronomical unit, light year, per sec. These are the bigger units. You have to learn these definitions also. Astronomical unit, define astronomical unit, this question may come. Light year, define per sec. These all you have to by heart. Alright. What is astronomical unit? 1 astronomical unit is equal to the mean distance between the earth and the sun. And its relation, of course, important. Astronomical unit is represented by capital A, capital U. So 1 AU equal to 1.496 into 10 to the power 11 meter. Smaller units. Few more smaller units which are very, very small are Armstrong and Fermi. So, here again you put tick mark here, Armstrong definition, it is 10 to the power minus 10th part of a meter. This relation is again important, 1 Armstrong 10 to the power minus 10 meter, 1 Armstrong 10 to the power minus 8 centimeter, or 1 Armstrong 10 to the power minus 1 nanometer. Similarly, 1 micron equal to 10,000 Armstrong and 1 nanometer equal to 10 angstrom. Fermi, it is 10 to the power minus 15th part of a meter. This relation important. 1 Fermi equal to 10 to the power minus 15 meter. Next, we are going to discuss regarding the unit of mass. You know, the SI unit of mass is kilogram. Kilogram definition, put tick over here, red box. 1 kilogram was defined as the mass of a cylindrical piece of platinum iridium alloy kept at International Bureau of Weights and Measures at Serbs near Paris. Few relations are given here which are smaller than kilogram. 1 gram 10 to the power minus 3 kg, 1 kg 1000 gram, 1 milligram 10 to the power minus 6 kg, or 1 milligram 10 to the power minus 3 gram. Kindly put tick mark which are the relations I am telling you now. 1 quintal, these are the bigger units. 1 quintal equal to 100 kilogram, 1 metric ton 10 quintal, or 1 metric ton 1000 kg. Non-metric unit of mass, if it is asked, you may say AMU, it is mainly used in chemistry, atomic mass unit. For measuring the mass of chemicals, we use 1 AMU definition may come. 1 AMU is 1 by 12, the mass of 1 carbon 12 atom. This relation, 1 AMU, it is also represented as small u. 1 u also you can say equal to 1.66 into 10 to the power minus 27 kg. Solar mass is the bigger unit of mass. So, 1 solar mass equal to 2 into 10 to the power 30 kg. See the next definitions and relations. Second definition, 1 second is defined as 1 by 86400th part of a mean solar day. And 1 second equal to 1 by 86,400 minutes and 1 minute equal to 60 seconds. That's why in place of 1 year, it is converted to second like this. 365 into 24 into 60 into 60. And speed of light is here, which is a constant. 3 into 10 to the power 8. After multiplying, you may check. See, this result will come 9.46 into 10 to the power 15 meter. When it is divided by 10 to the power 3, in order to convert meter to kilometer, it becomes 9.46 into 10 to the power 12 kilometer. Alright, two more relations are important here. 1 light minute and 1 light second. When you need to convert 1 light minute to meter, you need to multiply the velocity of light, that is 3 into 10 to the power 8 into 60 second, because 1 minute equal to 60 second. So it becomes 1.8 into 10 to the power 10 meter. This value is also important. You will memorize this value. 1 light second is equal to 3.10 to the power 8 meter per second into 1 second. So it becomes 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter. Listen children, question may also come. Write the meaning of the statement. Meaning of the statement, you may turn the page here, exercise, you see here, exercise, here is a question, page 10, question number 7, numerical. The distance of a star from the earth is 8.33 light minutes. What do you mean by this statement? Right? So, in order to solve this, means express the distance in meter, here two questions are asked. What is the meaning of the statement, as well as convert 8.33 light minute to meter? So, when you write the meaning of the statement, you have to take help of light year definition. The light year is the distance traveled by light in vacuum in 1 year, then it is light year. And if it is light minute, then the light year is the distance traveled by light in vacuum in 1 minute. That will be the meaning of the statement. And when you convert, you use this relation. 1 light minute equal to 1.8 into 10 to the power 10 meter. Therefore, 8.33 light minute is equal to 8.33 into 1.8 into 10 to the power 10 meter. When we will solve numericals once more, I am going to solve this for you. Now for the time 1 nanometer, so 1 angstrom equal to 1 by 10 nanometer. Therefore, unitary method is being followed. 5800 angstrom equal to 1 by 10 into 5800. So it becomes 580 nanometer. I think you followed this. Second part, you have to convert 5800 angstrom to meter. So we write 1 angstrom equal to 10 to the power minus 10 meter. Therefore, 5800 angstrom equal to 5800 into 10 to the power minus 10. After solving, it becomes 58 into 10 to the power minus 8 meter. You may leave your answer here also. Otherwise, as here it is given in your answer, in meter it is 5.8 into 10 to the power minus 7 meter. In one decimal place, it is represented. Generally, it is expressed like this. If you don't express it like this, here also if you leave your answer, then also it is correct. In order to convert it to one decimal place, what is done? 58 by 10. And up and numerator and denominator, both the places you multiply with 10. So 58 by 10 becomes 5.8 and 10 to the power minus 8 into 10 to the power 1. When we solve, it becomes 10 to the power minus 8 plus 1. So 10 to the power minus 7. So final answer is 5.8 into 10 to the power minus 7 meter. See the second question. The size of a bacteria is 1 micron. Find the number of bacteria in 1 meter length. So, we need to know the relation between micron and meter. 1 micron equal to 10 to the power minus 6 meter. 10 to the power minus 6, you can write like this. 1 by 10 to the power 6 meter. You can see here, negative part is converted to positive as soon as you are taking it to denominator place. Cross multiplication when you do, 1 meter equal to 10 to the power 6. See, here the question is, find the number of bacteria in 1 meter length. So, answer will be, in 1 meter length, 10 to the power 6 bacteria are there. Question number 4, first I am showing you. The wavelength of light is 589 nanometer. What is its wavelength in angstrom? First, you have to write the relation. 1 nanometer equal to 10 angstrom, as we know. Therefore, 589 nanometer equal to 589 into 10. So, 5890 angstrom. Next question, number 5. Mass of an oxygen atom is 60 new. 60 minutes, 1 hour, 3600 second. 1 day, 24 hour. If it is converted to second, then it is 86,400 second. Leap year, you know, leap year is the year in which the month of February is of 29 days. So, 1 leap year equal to 366 days. 1 decade, 10 years. If you convert it to second, it comes like this. 3.1536 into 10 to the power 8 second. 1 century, 100 years. 1 century is also equal to 36,524 days. Or 3.16 into 10 to the power 9 second. Millennium is of 1000 years. And in second it is 1 millennium equal to 3.16 into 10 to the power 10 second. I think you followed those relations I told right now. You have to by heart these relations. Few definitions, whatever I told you now, kindly by heart at home. And this table, page 7, this table is shown here. Take the help of these formulas under definition heading which are given. One formula you write down, substitute and take the values which are there at denominator place to the numerator place. Whenever you take them, power becomes negative. So, once you try this, if you have any problem, when we will start our classes, again I will show you on the board. These are the topics you have to by heart. Next, one more work I give you now here, page 9, open page 9. Question number 15, all these relations you will by heart. Question number 18, all these relations. Question number 24, and all these objectives. 24 to 28. Multiple choice type is also important. 1 to 5. Answers are already given here. You need to by heart all this. Definitions, whatever I told you, these are again given in exercise 1A. 1 to 14. These are the definitions, all short questions. 16, 17 also short questions. I have already discussed. You will by heart all this. And next, numericals, which I have already solved in the copy. Stepwise, I am going to show you. Continue. Actually, 16 atomic mass unit. Find its mass in kilogram. You need to write this relation. 1 atomic mass unit equal to 1.66 into 10 to the power minus 27 kilogram. Therefore, 16 atomic mass unit equal to 1.66 into 10 to the power minus 27 into 16 kilogram. After calculation, it comes 2.656 into 10 to the power minus 26 kilogram. Next is number 6. Here the question is, it takes time 8 minutes for light to reach from sun to the earth surface. If speed of light is taken to be 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second, find the distance from the sun to the earth in kilometer. One light year is equal to 9.46 into 10 to the power 12 kilometer. This relation you first write down. We know the general formula for distance. Distance equal to speed into time. Here you substitute the value of speed of light, that is 3 into 10 to the power 8 into time should be taken here as it is 8 minutes. So 8 into 60. Alright. Because 1 minute equal to 60 seconds. That's why 8 into 60. And it is expressed in meter. SI unit of distance. So meter is written. When you calculate, it comes 144 into 10 to the power 9 meter. Convert it to kilometer, divided by 10 to the power 3, then it becomes 144 into 10 to the power 6 kilometer. Alright? And 10 to the power 6 kilometer. When you are converting it to this one, one decimal place. So what you have to do, 144, you have to convert it to one decimal place, so divided by 100. Here also into 100, both the places. So 144 becomes 1.44 and it becomes 10 to the power 8 kilometer. One light year equal to 9.46, it is not applicable here, leave it. Now, question number 7. Right now, I told you the meaning of the statement comes. So, you have to write the distance traveled by light in vacuum in 1 minute is 8.33 meter. Alright. If you want to convert it to meter, you need to... Now, I told you the meaning of the statement comes. So, you have to write the distance traveled by light in vacuum in 1 minute is 8.33 meter. Alright. If you want to convert it to meter, you need to write this relation. 1 light minute equal to, see, turn the page. Page 4. 1 light minute equal to 1.8 into 10 to the power 10 meter. Therefore, 8.33 light minute equal to 8.33 into 1.8 into 10 to the power 10 meter. After calculating, it comes 1.45 into 10 to the power 11 meter. So, you round off and it comes 1.5 into 10 to the power 11 meter. Today, I am finishing the lesson section, section A of this chapter. Next class, I will continue with section B. Thank you.